So in 1942, January, I began to pick up the pieces, and I found out that my problem was to adopt the system to make it work in some of the new four-engine bombers which were about to come off the production line. Well, the first was to put in a Halifax bomber. And so I studied this, and I thought originally the problem might not be too difficult, because the echoes had been seen from perhaps scanner rotating in a small Blenheim aircraft. The problem with the Halifax is that the scanner could not be put in the nose of the aircraft. That was the first problem, because that was occupied by the bomb aimer and the forward gunner. So I decided to, amazing, you know, how one made all these decisions, made them oneself, apparently. I don't remember asking anyone else about it. I said, well, the only thing to do is to build the scanner under the bomb bay, under the fuselage, and put it in the perspex cupola, inverted perspex cupola. So I took a 3-foot scanner, cut it in half, not in half, sliced off the top and the bottom, and decided on the sort of depth I could have, and went to see Handy Page, who was the director of the firm making the Handy Page aircraft. And he summoned his chief engineer, chief designer, and I said, Mr. Handy Page, I'm asked if you would please mount this under one of your Halifax bombers so that we can put in this. Oh, never forgotten the atmosphere in the room. He said, put that under one of our bombers? It was out of the question. He said, we'd have to take the bombs out. We'd have to take most of them out anyhow. So I thought, but fortunately, was not rude enough to say it would be better to take a few bombs out and bolt the rest in the right place. Anyhow, I retired, because what could I do? I was still in my 20s. I couldn't order him to do this. But of course, things were quite different then. So I phoned Charwell and told him what I'd done. Well, you know, within a week or two, a Halifax bomber arrived at Herne Airport with the cupola fitted underneath. You see, it was my misfortune to suffer the highest priority. Churchill, as I will explain later, had ordered Charwell to do, and the Secretary of State for Air, who was Sinclair, to do this with the highest priority.